Greetings and welcome one and all to Robocraft and once again to the Mr Plow. It is the 6th of January and we have many things to work on. Now, before I really get down to what this episode is going to be focusing on, I just want to take a few moments to note that I have since learned that Robocraft won the Indie of the Year Awards over on IndieDB. Well done to everyone who took their time to vote. I'm very, very proud of Robocraft. Robocraft is doing very well lately. Now, in this episode, and the reason why we're here at the Mr. Plow, I don't intend to take Mr. Plow out again. We've spent enough time on Mr. Plow. However, what I do intend to do is this. Mr. Plough is metamorphizing. I'm not going to call it Plough, P-L-O-W. That was intentional because that's how the Simpsons spelled it, because the Simpsons are Americans. Or, well, I mean, the Simpsons aren't anywhere, but, you know, fictitiously, they're in fictitious America. But, no, we're going back to spelling Plough, the correct way to spell Plough. This is going to become the Sky Plough. Those of you who were at the Robocraft stream on Saturday saw how terribly badly I hashed up trying to make a similar kind of design to the Mr. Plow that would be a flyer. Yeah, that didn't go so well. So, we're going to be trying it again to make Mr. Plow work as a flyer, but we're going to have to think of... how are we going to do this? I'm thinking we're going to move this forward. See, that's the problem with this. I don't necessarily want the center of thrust to be too close to the center of lift. I really do wish there was some indication of where these points lay on the bot. I really, really wish for that. But we don't really get it, alas. So what we're going to have to do instead is we're going to turn that upside down. We're going to do the same on this side. Actually, that's already turned upside down the correct way. Did I have that the wrong way? Interesting. But we're also going to pull these back, I think. I'm going to have one of these come down, like so. And the same on this side. Oh, well, I would do the same on this side. Apparently, I don't have any more of those cubes. What kind of shenanigans are this? And let me go and buy some more. We'll buy plenty so that I don't have to worry about that again for a little while. Right, okay. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to put that there and then we're going to anchor this pointing up on either side. There we are. That is taking away a little bit of the problem there. Now, we are going to be keeping the skis. The skis are very, very important. Now, got a lot of thrust back here. I don't want to move these thrusters too far forward, but I guess I could possibly... make do with that. Now, the thing here is that if we're having our weapon... If we're making a flyer, then we're going to need our weapons to be down here somewhere. Though that would only really be a concern if we were making a bomber. Ooh. Could this possibly be a good interceptor? It might be. You know what, we'll take off those large thrusters on the sides and let's just get some wings on here. We want, we don't have any tier 5 aerofoils. We ideally want tier 6 aerofoils, so I'm going to buy two of those. And we're going to buy three tier 6 rudders as well. We'll use these first to see what we can do. So we want the tier 6 aerofoils. Now, is this really going to mess up everything? Yes, it kind of is. Okay. Well, I do sort of want these shields, so let's see what we can do without getting rid of them. We might be lucky. We might actually be able to make something work here. We've got some lift already, thanks to the helium that we've got on this bot. So we might not need to worry too much about that. Now, if we're making this an interceptor, of course, we want to take these away. And, in fact... The more I think about it, the more I don't want those there, really. These would be good points for guns at the top. We might even be able to get some good points for guns at the bottom. But the problem is these skis. We've got a very, very low profile. There's not much room for the undercarriage for us to fix weapon systems. But we'll have to have a look. So that's one rudder. We could have the second rudder around here, I would say. Maybe. Maybe yes. Yes, we can actually fit it. The vapor trails can go somewhere else. Let's dig this down a little bit and we'll see what we can do here as well. Now, at the moment, we're just building this to see if we can get it to fly at all. And then we'll have to redesign it to see if we can't get the guns to be in some sort of reasonable position. We'll have the vapor trails underneath, I think. Would be the better place to put them. Really? Oh, okay. The vapor trails will interfere massively with the skis, apparently. I wasn't really planning for that, but okay. We'll have the vapor trails up here then, pride of place. They can just stick in there behind the shields. We'll get rid of you as well. In fact, we'll take all the weapon systems off entirely and then see what we can do. Now, there was one thing that I realized in my build tutorial for the Mr. Plow. I forgot one fairly important thing, actually. And that was, we had no reverse thrust. So, I should probably try and fix that while I have an opportunity to do so. I could have reverse thrust about here. It shouldn't be much. We just want to be able to get it to go backwards just a little bit. This shouldn't be a normal mode of travel for the Mr. Plow, so we're not going to put a lot of thrusters toward this task. However, we are going to have a few more than we've got, so let's go and buy another two tier 4. Where are you? There we are. Very cheap these days. And there we go. We want these there and there. That way they'll be perfectly balanced. All right, let's have a quick look. Can this fly? It might be able to. Might not. We have got the skis, so it should be easy enough to get off the ground. And now with the added lift from our wings, let's see. Oh, it just wants to fly. It flat out does not want to go down. Or it does just a tiny bit, but let's see. Oh, that is glorious. Look at that. That is really nice. It's not very fast, though. But then again, I've taken off a huge amount of its forward thrust. Look at this. That is beautiful. It is literally dancing in the skies. I mean, I say that a lot. Usually, when I'm saying that, it's more of a flailing, a panicked, you know, writhing around in the atmosphere. But no, this, the sky plow, is plowing the clouds with some ease. It's making flying look easy, and that is not an easy thing to do, frankly. Oh, this is beautiful. This could be a contender. This could make a name for itself as an interceptor. It is agile enough. But every part of me is saying, make it a bomber. Don't make it an interceptor. Make it shoot giant things at ground targets. I have bad luck with interceptors, as you may well have noticed. But suffice it to say, that can fly well. Question is, can we make it fight well? So we're going to have a look at that next. There are two places that I can place thrusters, though. Two spots, here and at the top, around there. Whether I do or not, I'm not sure. But let's have a quick look at what we can do with plasmas. We definitely can't fit any here. The skis are in the way. I mean, the most obvious place to put these would be out a little bit, around, tucked behind the shield, but problem is then, we've got this to contend with. Let's just have a quick look. If I did this, could I fit a tier 6 plasma gun there? I could, in exchange for just these. So one of the downward thrusters would have to go, but I could have that there. That is interesting to me. I can definitely afford to lose that, in my opinion. Let's get that set up. So we've got two tier 6 plasmas. Let's see if we can have two tier 7s. No. That is a little bit too much. We're lacking on space, really, here. That's the main thing. We are definitely hurting for space. But the plasma launcher itself, is that going to interfere with the skis? It will. It's definitely going to be a bit of a problem with the skis. One thing we can do to fix that is just drop all of the skis by one. And probably a good idea to give it a little bit of ground clearance. As I've mentioned, that is one of the main reasons that we are having troubles right now. So we'll drop all of the skis by one. We want to try and keep this as close and tight a fit as we can. So part of that is us not just making unnecessary changes. Now, the thing with this is I can extend this out, but I don't think that's going to help us get T7 plasmas on it. I guess it won't matter too much if we have T7 plasmas, as long... Oh, we could get rid of this shield. I wonder, we could move the shield up one. That would still work, I think. No, that would interfere with... Well, I can move that down. I can always have that one move down. Move elsewhere. We'll reposition the flag. In fact, we could easily do this. We've got this much extra room here. There's no reason not to. So let's go ahead and create a little platform. In fact, we'll use those inners. I really couldn't believe that I hadn't used inners here. So we'll go ahead and do that. And I just noticed that my microphone has been slowly sliding down. I clearly haven't tightened the stand properly. Give me just a moment. There we go. If you were wondering why I was getting quieter and quieter as this episode was going on, there we are. Sorry about that. Hopefully it wasn't too bad. I'll have to listen to the recording, and if it is really bad, I'll have to re-record this entire episode again. Oh, that would be a pain. But we should now be able to have two tier 7 plasma artillery at the front. Now, they're going to be heavy. They're going to be very, very weighty components, and that's not something that I'm looking forward to. Can I move this up? Could you sit there instead? No. That would be asking for too much. Because what I'm thinking is that realistically, if we're going to do that on this side as well, then I'm going to need to push these back. But now here's the thing. If I put that there, could I fix this? Yes, I could. Oh, no, perhaps I can't. Ah, it's interfering with the aerofoil. Okay. That is going to be a bit of an issue, I think. There's a part of me that doesn't mind too much losing this rear shield, but at the same time, it is part of the design. It's a fair part of the design, too. Let's see if I move that back another one, whether that would work. It would. I couldn't really do it here. Or could I? Let's have a quick look at it. We'll see what this looks like if I were to do that. No, it would interfere with the rudder. Okay, well, that's fine. Didn't really want to do that anyway. Simply because it would make this look so awkward. But it's making it look awkward anyway, I suppose. So let's just do that. Now, we have some options open to us. Let's get rid of you. Could we affix another one of these? No, not quite. But. If we place that out there, we might be able to. Yes, we can. Okay, we are starting to get somewhere now. We've still got ground clearance. The skis are still going to be better. The skis are still going to be in contact with the ground before the plasmas. So we've lost a little bit of reverse thrust. But I can reposition that without too much problem, I imagine. And we just need to move these around a little bit. I really do. I am actually kind of worried about the mic moving. And it's on my mind at the moment. It's like, am I really going to have to re-record all this? Should I really just stop and check? I should. But you know what? No. We're going to be brave. We're going to hope. And if it does turn out that I need to re-record, well, there we go. That's kind of terrible. But if it doesn't, then I will be rewarded for my bravery. I will take the possibility of bravery rewards over the certainty of not wasting any time. any day. Right, let's find my thrusters again. We need some reverse thrust. And we want it... we could fit it there, but I don't want to put it there. It would be the best place to put it, though, as well. I guess we could. I'm going to need to buy some more cubes. Fair enough. Let me go and grab those. And we should be in a position, then, to give this a test. 4 plasmas is okay for a bomber, in my opinion. Ideally, more. But we've already gone into tier 7, actually, as well. Well, I could replace the forward ones with T6s. Let's try that out, because that would definitely reduce the impact on our placement in the tiers. There we go. We might even be able to afford another one underneath. I'll have to have a look at that one in a second, though, because we don't really want to be filling this up with weapons when, in reality, I still want to investigate being able to fit 2 more thrusters on here. Those 2 thrusters, of course, would be going in the middle. Now, we had tier 5 thrusters, or rather tier 6 thrusters. We'll see. Can we fit these in? We should be able to if we're very, very lucky. This needs to turn around. You can work off that block instead. And then I should be able to affix this, roughly speaking, there, I believe. Or even maybe a little bit further forward. But I think... Ah, just pulled us into tier 7. Drat, damn and blast! Perhaps I could sacrifice these. I don't think they're going to make enough of a difference. They are not. Perhaps we could sacrifice some of the helium now, though. Since we don't really need it. We've got enough lift from the fact that we're a flyer. Let's get rid of you. That has pulled us down quite a lot. In fact, let's go ahead and take the helium off this side. We are going to keep some of the helium. I'm not sure if we could do completely without it. But we should be able to work like this. Yes, I think we can. In fact, with that, we might even be able to... upgrade these. Let's have a quick look. Can we afford to upgrade these to tier 7s? I think we're asking for a lot. Yes, we would be asking for far too much. But this could easily get into tier 7. If we were willing to take it there, we could make this a tier 7 bot. I'm not sure I am willing to do that. In fact, I'm fairly certain I'm not. But I could. And that is the main point. Let's see, if we were to affix some more tier 6s, one there, no, too much. But we could have one at the front. I'm not going to, I'm happy with this. Alright, let's see how this does. I guess the only other thing that I could really affix to this would be, let's see, we could try it. I could upgrade the radar as well. That might be useful, get a higher tier radar. But I could also have one of these, just affixed at the top. That is going to be a massive target to get shot off, but, well, it is what it is. Now, the only other thing that I could think of doing is to fortify the wings a little bit with a bit of armor. And that may well be something I look at doing. But for now, let's just take this out. It's a fragile craft, certainly. But hopefully it is a fast one, and hopefully it can put out quite a bit of damage. So, might not need to worry too much. Maybe this can be one of those glass cannon kind of crafts. Its intention is to get out there and die valiantly, having taken out like 5 or 6 of the enemy team. Let's drop a plasma barrage there. And quickly move away as if that was an enemy team. Obviously a little bit choppy because it's loading in more and more bots as we go. Let's drop plasma barrage about there. How high can we go? Where is our ceiling? Keep going. That's right. Keep going. Oh, that's our ceiling by the looks of it. Very well. This is still reasonably high up. It's not as high as I would like, but I think that's as high as we're going to get. The rear rudder is pretty well protected. We don't have much shielding at the bottom. We have a reasonable amount of shielding at the front, which isn't necessarily that useful to us. But at the same time, it looks awesome. And the craft has pretty much kept its fighter jet aesthetic going. I'm not sure. It is probably not the best design at the moment, but I am finding it hard to find it in myself to care. This looks awesome, and I think that's almost the most important part. I make plenty of flyers, though not all of them work very well. Most of the ones that do look like blobs in the sky, so now that I've got a flyer that doesn't, I'm finding it hard to care that it might not work as well as the others. But I am a little bit worried about the aerofoils there. They do look like they are fragile and could be blown off at a moment's notice. But I think it's good enough for us to take out and have a bit of a test. Yes. I think we shall meet back here when I've got a bit of a battle going. So see you soon. And welcome back. We are fighting along the side the likes of Death from Above, which I can only imagine is a flyer, and Smurf Tank. Where is Smurf Tank? Smurf Tank better be blue. Is that Smurf Tank? I can only assume that it is. Okay, right, well, we need to get up into the air. The first battle went well. We won, but unfortunately, I hadn't turned on chat. And because I wasn't able to be dapper with saying good luck, have fun, I'm not going to include it. I don't want records of my undapperness on the internet, my lord. However, that does mean we don't have the first victory of the day bonus, but oh well. A reasonable price to pay to preserve my dapperness. Right, have we got any enemies? We have. Plasma bombs away. Is that even going to hit? It did! My lord, it took off half his bot. I'm remarkably pleased. Though he's getting healed, so he does have a medic over yonder. Alright then. Now, let's spin around again for another attack. It looks like, from what I've seen, my plasmas will get in the way of themselves. So, sorry, the skis will get in the way of the plasmas. So I either need to be facing where I'm about to attack, or I need to show my underbelly before I fire the load. So, yeah, not so great design there. Wow, are you a jumper? It looks like you are. Let's see over here. I'm not fancying flying over that bed of SMGs there. That looks like death, but I might try to take out the logistics. In fact, I'm really tempted to try that. We've got an enemy flyer. We've got a healer just down there. And where are you going there? No, probably not. All right, well, I'll come in for another attack then. And we've got a plasma. No. Is that a plasma? I don't think so. But got a lot of people just gathered up there. That was pretty good. And hello to you. Goodbye to you. All right, we want to come around for another attack on that massive nest of enemies. Let's see if we can't get our belly showing. And bombs away. Did we actually hit the medic? Yes, we did. Let's try that again. Bombs away again. There we go. Medic is out for the count. And back around for another bombing run. We want to go for Jep. Fire. Did we do enough damage? I don't think we did. We need to do it again. Fire. Don't run away from your ally. You're a medic. Even if you haven't got any guns, you should be trying to block damage from him with your body. You should die for such dishonorable conduct as a medic. I shall conduct the execution myself. He who passes the judgment should do the deed, it seems. It's something like that Ned Stark said. I can't remember, honestly. I flubbed it massively. But still, the sentiment is still true. Right. CPU destroyed, 1,268. Kills 3. Assists 1. Scouts 3. Not a bad run. I am really liking this bomber. Despite my concerns about it being fairly weak, or rather fragile, I should say. I'm actually fairly impressed. Now, there's one thing I could do here. And I'm wondering if I should. This would be an obvious upgrade. For lift. Sorry, for speed. It'd be to do something like this. But it would also be an enormous cost. Yeah. I can't afford to do this. This would push us just into tier 7, though. It's not actually that much of a push. I wonder, could I pull these off? Oh, I'm really close. Getting really close to pulling this back down. You know what? How about these instead? You know, I think that had a bigger effect on pulling down our rank than removing our E-War. So let's pop those back on. Yes, indeed. It seems that this helium, I'm going to keep it there for now. But it does appear that whenever I need to pull our rank down a little bit, that's where I should be looking. As you'll notice, after I just came out of the battle where I'd forgotten to turn on chat, I made a slight adjustment. We've put in some extra thrust, extra upward thrust, and extra downward thrust just on these limbs to make use of that new real estate for our thrusters. But yes, I'm liking that. That should actually be a decent upgrade for our speed here. Right, I think we've got enough time for one more battle, so I'm going to go and find us a good fight to fight in. See you soon. And welcome back. It looks like we have another happy 2015. There are a lot of happy 2015s in the game at the moment. Really, does no one think to change the name of their bot? I just don't know. We've got one healer, two healers. We've got one, two SMGs, three SMGs, a rail, two plasmas, three including myself. No flyers, though. That I'm a little bit concerned about, I've got to be honest, because if we don't have a lot of other flyers, then I am going to be drawing a lot of attention. The moment they notice me up there, if their SMG players are worth their salt, then they will be prioritizing me. That is frightening. So I'm going to skirt around the outsides for now. We'll keep an eye out for potential victims, but I'm not going to move too far forward. Got a flyer over there. Let's drop a couple of plasmas there. I really need our SMGs to take him on, please, because he will ruin my day. I think my day is about to be ruined, whether I like it or not. Let's see if we can hit. Not far off, though. And again, once more, I forgot to properly change my direction to account for where I'm about to fire. Let's drop some plasmas there. That hurt. That is hurting. Let's try and duck down. There we go. Oh, beautiful dive there. You are doing quite well. Let's get in towards the medic. Grab a little bit of healing while we can. Hello. Thank you very much. I'm not sure what we lost, but a little bit of healing is always good. Ooh, we are being targeted, though, once again. Let's drop some plasmas over yonder. We may actually hit something. We did. I'm pretty pleased with that. And again. Uh-oh. Once more, getting shot. In the shields, though, interestingly. Which I'm surprised with because my shields are fairly hard to hit. They're in the front. So I'm getting hit from behind in the shields. How that's working, I'm not sure. But we've got a few baddies up here that we really want to deal with. It's trying... Oh, that's going to hurt. I'm thinking we're going to go down. But we'll do our best for our team while we can. And that's it for us. My plasma's facing the right way. Kind of, and not at the same time. Ooh, the shield is up. If I can just turn around, I've lost the ability to turn in one direction. See if we can't get you. I need to get behind here if I'm going to survive. My shields have done a fantastic job of keeping me going, but I've lost my aerofoils. How are we doing against the enemies? We've got one over yonder. Let's try and get up and fire. I did actually hit, but not sure how much damage I did. Did a decent little bit there, and again. Oh, thank you very much, medics. Go on, race forward, destroy the enemy, and hopefully give me back my wings, and I will be able to help. Thank you very, very much. All I need is my aerofoils and my thrusters. Once I've got these, I'm back in the sky. Those shields, as much as I was saying, oh, I don't need them, they're at the front, they're not in the right place for me, really, as a bomber. They're actually doing remarkably well. Alright, let's get up there and try and take on this bomber. If we're the more maneuverable one, we might be able to do it. And... but there. Nope, that was bad. We've got a rail sniper down there that we want to destroy. We're taking a lot of damage here, necessarily, but we're going to keep on the tail of this bomber if we can. We did get him, but it's probably going to have cost us enormously. Let's get down there. Try if you can to remain on your skis. Fantastic work there. Let's get over here, get some more healing. Our team is doing remarkably well at keeping us going. The healers are doing a fantastic job. Thank you very much. Truly, you are nothing like the enemy healer on the other team in the last battle. You are fantastic, Apothecaries. I am going to put in a good word with your chapter leader. There we go. Let's get a little bit more damage on you. Let's try not to crash as well. That's probably a very important part. Let's get a bit of a bomb there. We need another one. And again. Oh, that was bad. We flipped over. I didn't notice. That is the greatest peril when flying and you lose a wing. All right, let's get back up there if we can. And there. No, I don't think that's going to help anyone. Certainly not going to help me. We've got some enemies over there. Well done, we actually won. I don't feel like I contributed as much in that battle as I did in the previous one. But still, I think it was not too bad to have survived it, considering how many times I got my wing shot off. But yeah, I'm not too happy about how many times I got my wing shot off. I think that's a good indication that we do actually need the armor here. So, with that said, let's go ahead and reconfigure my thrusters back to the old configuration. And I think we are probably going to need to bring out some armor, as I was expecting. But I'm not going to do that all on camera. Well, I guess it's not actually that hard to do. Actually, it is. It's going to take me time to get all the parts. But when you return in the next episode, I will more than likely have armored out the wings, or at least this, like the halfway of them, and branched that out properly so they've got a little bit of added protection. Still, the armor will easily get blown off, so I might extend that armor out and actually have this thruster one further down. I may even armor the top. I'm not sure yet, but we'll have to see in the next episode. I do hope you've enjoyed this one. I am reasonably pleased with how well the Sky Plow is coming along. I think it's going to be very interesting as we upgrade this through the tiers. But that is it for now. So, until next we meet, and as always, do take care.